And okay, it's I am from Moscow Power Engineering Institute. My chair is hot fusion, not cold fusion, but strange situation. I study the cold fusion. It's a great pleasure to inform you, to tell you about our last experimental results. I hope these results will be interesting for you. The name of my presentation is here, Water Plasma Reactor. I told you about design of the design of this reactor for the creation underwater plasmoids. I would like to remember you that in last conference in Padua, I told about another reactor named Plasma Vertex Reactor. This reactor very good because of this machine is designed, tested, and we have a patent for this machine. And I remember that the main principle of the plasma vertex reactor consists of the creation of the swirl flow, gas flow, and here you see nozzle, and three and four, this is electrodes for the creation of the electrical discharge. And so it's very simple to use this RF flow calorimeter for the measuring of the extra energy of the this cross section when we create outgoing gas flow mixture. And initial parameters of this gas flow we measured in this section before discharge area region. In this slide, you can see the realization of this discharge area plasma inside of this swirl vertex, and you see the additional injection of the lithium additive to the nickel electrode, and we used water steam argon mixture, and in some cases we add some of the additives to improve the extra energy release. But during exploitation of this setup, we have obtained some of the problems concerning to the design of this machine. In this picture, you hear this problem. Thermal heat exchanges very difficult to combine with this reactor. Why? There is destruction of the flow, vertex flow, and so it's this machine very sensitive to the combination of any exchangers with the reactors. It's the first. Relatively low initial pressure inside of the test section. I sure that it's insufficient for the acceleration of the low energy nuclear reactions. And according to my opinion, according to my experience, it's need more higher initial stage pressure in order to accelerate it and convert this almost combustion process up to detonation process very quickly energy release energy power release in this reactor. Small operation time connected with large erosive Cassot mass flow rate, about 10 milligrams per second, and very difficult to exchange, change the new electron and moving of this electrode because of the length of the electrode will be shorter and shorter, and there is some of the technical problem. Once more about this machine, I mentioned that testing gas mixture is argon plus water steam. The output thermal power of this machine up to 10 kilowatts, not 100 watts. The small installation when I listened to some of the presentation, but 10 kilowatts. I assure that this machine is unique in the world, and input electrical energy for the creation plasma about less than 1 kilowatt. So the coefficient of the performance reach up to value 10, and in the this cross section we create very overheating water stream with the temperature about 900 Celsius. It's sufficient for the using of this reactor as a combustion chamber in the turbine engine. And today we will start the process of combination of this reactor in the turbine engine design. Main experimental conclusions, main conclusions obtained during the works with this reactor was the very high specific heat power of nanocluster fuel. Nanocluster, what means nanocluster? It's erosion of the cassot and creation of nanocluster clouds, maybe region of which interacts with the hydrogen from the dissociation of the water vapor in discharge area. And this value will be connected very simple. We measure this value mass flow rate of the erosion electrode, and we have measured the extra power input output in our reactor, and so the specific heat power is about 100 up to 1,000 EV per atom. It's very important value for the physical, for the future physical model, but not mega EV and not EV typical to the chemistry or mega EV typical to for the atomic nuclear reactor. So the physics of this phenomena may be connected with the absolutely different theoretical approach. To solve the problem of the improvement of the design of our reactor, we had some of the numerical simulation of the operation mode of this reactor, and here you see arranged of the swirl generator. It's a nozzle, it's electrode system, and very strange effect for us connected with the localization of the very hot plasma, namely here, and in order to obtain the hot outgoing gas flow, it's a very bad situation because of exchange of the external flow and internal flow very small. This geometry of the cathode more better because of we have prolongation of the hot plasma to the nozzle, and this phenomenon is connected with the creation of reverse vertex flow from the electrode system up to swirl generator. And so we heated not the nozzle, gas near nozzle, but we heated in this reactor the another end of this reactor. So to obtain reliable and colorimetric measurements in this device very, very difficult. And so new design of such machine was made our team, and here you see a new type of the generators, plasma vertex, reactor with liquid cathode, and it's you see the heat exchanger, and the experiment will be done in the water bath colorimeter. Here you see the water volume, and so and swirl generator region and cathode generator cathode is empty, arranged inside of the water volume. And the vertex creates from this device unit and reflected from this liquid and have an output nozzle in this barbotage units. This bubbles creates the bubbles and heat exchanges between the bubbles and water colorimeter. I don't know why. And here you see the general view of this reactor, and you see the realization of the plasma inside of this reactor. And here you see the power supply. And unfortunately, very large problem with the demonstration of this video, but it's operation mode of this reactor without water colorimeter. And namely in this device, reactor, we obtained control testing, calibration experiments, and it's very interesting that the measuring of the electric power and water heat of this calorimeter was the same, and the value of COP was very close to one. So the thermal losses in this setup was very small. And a maximal value of COP was obtained in the pure water steam. In this case, we have a coefficient of performance about 5. Very strange results we obtained when we use different testing gas mixtures. You see the testing mixture helium and hydrogen and nickel electrode. You see through the 10 minutes a large number of the suits. And okay, and according results of this chemical and IDC analysis, we have obtained many of the realization of the in this analysis, we measured large concentration of the carbon and another elements. And so the same results we obtained in the electrode surface. And I would like the optical spectrum, very interesting, when we use lithium OH solution, and you see creation not only OH and hydrogen, but also N2. What means N2? And CO, what means CO? It's impossible to obtain in this mixture. And processing of the this optical spectra give us the plasma temperature about 5,000 KV. And when we increase the electrical current, you also obtain the same spectrum with high concentration of hydrogen and CO. Unfortunately, I have no time. I would like to show some of the pictures of the different design of the this reactor. And here you see the reactor for the generation and obtaining very cheap hydrogen and extra thermal power. It's main our experimental results, very cheap hydrogen, namely in this reactor. Okay, here you can see the high speed video when plasmoids creates between two electrodes underwater surface. Once more, this the main our experimental results obtained in the water plasma water reactor and the plasma vertex reactor. The same value was obtained in this experiment, and according to my opinion, these results most important for the future development of the physical model Lenner in plasmoids system. Thank you very much.
You used in your second design, better design of the reactor, lithium hydroxide. How did you get this lithium hydroxide? Lithium hydroxide.
It's a solution. We add some of the lithium to the clean water.
Okay, how about the actually the purity of initial lithium which you have used?
0.1 mole lithium OH we used in our experiments. 0.1 mole.
Okay, thank you, Dr. Klimov. Okay, we have one more question here.
Can you show just a spectral analysis of the on the screen, this one? I just want to point out about the CO and N2 you found in the spectral analysis. The work in Kevren work talked about the CO and N2. These molecules are very similar. For example, distance between C and O is 1.09 angstrom, and between two atoms of nitrogen are 1.12 angstrom. So they are very similar, and they have a very similar, you know, properties. So maybe it's one of them, and they combine with the
maybe,
oxygen.
Maybe.
That's it.
But for me, it's very strange. N2, no initial guess has no N2 in the large concentration. No, only helium, only water steam, and very strange situation. N2 with a large concentration. But it is possible if you combine. For example, if you have unusual suggestion, fantastic suggestion, that it's possible this reaction, creation of the soot particles, and N2 is no problem. It's very simple. One step to see carbon, and the second step, nitrogen.